Hello everybody, welcome to today's video. Today's video we're going to do a pretty glam look, I think. It's going to have long lashes, dark under eyes, which I normally don't do. I told you I don't tight line on the bottom with dark. Well, today we're going to do it. So, let's get ready. Let's get started. And it's going to be a mixture of high-end and drugstore makeups, because I'm going to start off with a drugstore foundation, because I put up a picture a few days ago and I asked if anybody wanted me to do that look, so that's what we're going to try and do, because they said yes. Well, they liked it, so I'm assuming that's yes. And I got a couple of yeses. So that's what we're going to do, and let's get started. And the foundation I'm going to be using today is the new Wet n Wild. I don't know how new it is. I think it's new. It says new. Wet n Wild. I have to put my glasses on because I can't see. It's something about photo. Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. And I have the color Golden Beige. I have no idea if it's right. It's usually not. I am so incredibly horrible at picking drugstore colors for me. They're always too dark. I always think I'm darker than I am, I guess. But we'll see, huh? Okay, we're going to start with this. And I'm going to try and go fast because it's going to be like a whole face one. And so I'm going to tell you about it for a minute. And then as I do it, I'm not going to talk so that I can go fast. It has this little paddle thing in here. So that's what I'm going to use. I'm just going to put it all over. Ooh, that was a lot right there. And then I am going to use, I have a beauty blender here, and then I have the Real Tech one. I recently tried the Real Tech, and I didn't really like it as well as my beauty blender, because it's squishier and I feel like it absorbs too much product. So I'm gonna use, for my foundation, I'm gonna use the beauty blender, but I really like the flat side on the Real Tech, so I'm gonna use that for my concealer. And I don't use the brush on this because it seems kind of thin. That's the only reason. So anyways, let's just do it before it. Okay, so next is my RCMA palette. I'm using the orange one right here. It's not really orange, it's a darker color and it's got a lot of orange in it, and that's what I'm gonna use for my color corrector and the dark circles under my eyes, which I showed you in a different video. This time I'm not gonna use a brush because I'm trying to hurry because this is gonna be a really long video. And I'm just gonna use my finger, because I am going to put light concealer right over the top of it, so it doesn't matter too much how, you know, whether there's lines in it or anything. It doesn't matter. It just needs to correct these purple spots. Yeah, I probably should use a brush though, because it worked really good on this side, but on this side I seem to be unable to do it, so we'll use the brush. And I'm using an e.l.f. brush. It's a little tiny with the yellow top. It's either for concealer or it may be lips. I'm not sure. They don't write it on their brushes, and it's on the package when you get it. But I've had it for a while, and I don't remember what it said. So I get to use it for whatever I want, because I can't remember what it's supposed to be used for. Oh, I got a lot of orange on that one. It's okay, we'll just cover that right up. And I always go up a little bit because I have little kind of saggy baggy skin right there, and it's kind of purple. It's because it's saggy baggy, it's more condensed, so it looks more purple. It's really not any different of a color, it's just fleshier, which makes it look darker. Okay, that's all I'm gonna do for the, I just wanted to get rid of some of that purpleness. So now we'll do concealer. soon as I find it. It's always lost. And I'm using the Maybelline Age Rewind in the color Natural. You guys, it's the same one I almost always use. I'm going to use the Real Tech one for the powder, for the baking, just because it's a lot drier. And I don't want it to not go on my skin. I want it to stick to the skin, not the sponge. Okay, now I'm gonna leave that to bake while I do my eyes so that the fallout hopefully won't stick. And let's see, we are gonna use the Naked 2 Basic palette today. You know how I like it, it's upside down, there you go. Naked 2. Ugh, so hard to open. And I'm going to start with the second one over here, second to the lightest, to do my transition on my eye, and I always do the transition first. Some people do the lid first, but if I do the lid first, I just have to redo it because it never has enough. Something, I don't know, but I always have to redo it. So that's why I do transition first. And for my transition, I try and pull it up almost to the brow. Because this helps my droopiness look less droopy. I know I'm doing it a lot. Probably because I can't really see in this mirror very good. Okay, and now I'm going to take the same brush and I'm going to the next color down right here, the third one. And I'm pretty much going to go in the crease and a little bit higher. So then you take your fluffy brush, and I don't, told you before, I don't have fancy named ones. These are ones I've had that I probably got at Walmart. But basically you just draw little circles and then do your windshield wiper thing just to blend in that second color that you put in. And then use this e.l.f. brush. It's just a little shadow brush. And I'm going to use the first color, the lightest color, for the lid. And I pretty much go all the way across because I'm going to add more color to the outside, but it's going to be dark, so it'll go right over the top of it. Could probably have used a little bit larger of a brush, but it just works. And I always go into the corner here in the middle. And then I want to take this same light color and do just a little line under the brow. We are going to go in with a darker color. And we're going to use this little brush. It's an angle. It's got an angle on it. And that's what I'm going to use for my darker color, and I'm going to use the fourth color. We're basically going in a row. The fourth color down, it's brown, and it has a name, but I can't read it. Get some color on there, and then you're just going to have to get close up of this one, and because I don't want to get it all over. And I tried to pull it in onto my lid a bit too, and then up into the V out here. And then into the crease. I'm just using what's already on the brush to try and make it closer to what the other one is. And I'm going to put another color on top of it anyway, so it's okay. So now I'm actually going to take a fluffier brush and just take the next color in line and put just a little bit on it, and then basically just blob it in this corner a little bit. And I want it, because I'm going to pull it into, on the, like halfway into the lid. So then, take your fluffy brush again. And try and blend that in onto the movable lid a little bit. Okay, that's it. That's it for shadows. We're gonna move on. And of course, we're gonna move right on into the liner. And I am going to use a new one. I know that I almost always use that L'Oreal Infallible Lacquer Liner, but because this one's taking a long time, I am going to use a pencil. This is a Rimmel pencil. Sparkle black? I didn't mean to get sparkle black. Boy, we're really going to be awesome. Yeah, it's sparkle black. So I'll try it, but I don't know if I'm going to keep it on. I may go back to the lacquer stuff. Okay, what do you think? Pretty bad, huh? That's okay, we're going to bring some more color down there. We're gonna take this smudgy brush right here, smudgy brush, and we are going to bring down this dark brown that we put in the corner and put it down here. Help blend out some of that yucky black glittery stuff. Pull that up. Do it on this side. Help pull that up. I know the wing is a lot bigger on that side, but we're gonna make it smaller on this side with our trick. And then I'm gonna take same brush for the next lighter color that we put on top, and I'm gonna blur that down here too. Yep. We're gonna get some, pretty much the colors we used on top, we're using on the bottom. At least the darker ones. gonna pull them up into that. And then I think we're even gonna take this little barrel brush here and put a little bit of the next lighter color and blur it down there too. So we're really using most of the colors we used on top on the bottom too. And then take our fluffy brush. I'm gonna take this bigger fluffy brush and just get rid of some of the overflow. And that's it for shadow and liner. And then we're going to do our brows. I always am gonna do my brows before, because this part right now would look better if I had already done my brows, but I haven't, so I'll do them now. I don't have any brow gel. I was gonna get some and I couldn't figure out what to get. I wanted to get drugstore kind, and one YouTuber, I think it was Sugarpuff Nisha, said the name of a good brow gel that's a drugstore one, and I couldn't remember which kind it was. So I didn't get one because I wanted to come back and watch it and get the one she said. Because I don't feel like for a brow gel, I need the high-end one. Maybe, but I don't think so. So anyways, I'm gonna do my brows. And I don't know if you guys can see from there, but they're kind of scraggly because I'm trying to reshape them a little bit. They got a little thin, especially right in here. So I'm trying to let them fill in. And for me, when I'm trying to let my brows fill in, I pretty much have to leave them alone, because otherwise I'll just pluck them back to the way they were. And since I want them to grow in here some more. So I don't know if you guys can see me do my brows, but this is Anastasia Beverly Hills. It's not the Brow Wiz, it's a newer one, because I feel like the Brow Wiz runs out too fast. This is Anastasia Beverly Hills Soft Brow. Brow Definer. This is a Brow Definer. Anyways, and it's in medium brown, I think. I don't see the color. Oh, maybe soft brown, that's the color. Okay, it's a Brow Definer in soft brown. And it could be a little darker for me, just because even though my hair's light, it's not real. And my brows are a little, some of them are dark and some of them are non-existent. And then there's always the white glow-in-the-dark ones that appear, which is why I need brow gel for those guys. Still didn't get on these fallout spots. And I never really know which way I want to go till I get there when I do my brows. But I feel like I should start with a nice defined line on the bottom, because that's where I need the fill-in part, is right here. So I feel like if they're too thin, I can go back and add more to the top. But I also want them to go in a little further in the middle. And whenever I get done with them, they always look like I should wipe that off, because there's not really any hairs there. I mean, there are a few, but not enough to call it real. It's good. All right, so that one's done. Let's see if the other one will match. Get out of the way. Yeah, this one's even scragglier than the other one. So I will take my setting powder. This is how I set my eyebrows too. Even though it kind of lightens them, especially right there where there's not really any hair, I just put some setting powder there to help keep it from like wiping off the first time I scratch my eyebrow. And then yeah, that's it. Doesn't look better with eyebrows than it did without. So now I'm going to, finish my face with my bronzer and my blush, my highlight. And then all we've got left is our eyebrows and our lips. And I use this, it's an e.l.f. brush, I think. It's a, or no name brush. I don't know if it's e.l.f., but it's no name. And it's just a flat brush. And I use Hoola bronzer. And I just make a nice angled line right there on both sides. You know what? I forgot the brush. I always forget something. Forgot the brush that I use to do my nose. So I will try to do it with this brush, I think. Okay, I have no idea why my camera keeps turning off, but so far we've done angles, chin, and then I did all up around here and around and down my sides of my neck. So we're good there. I'm gonna do my nose. That's what I was starting to do when it turned off, or when I noticed it was off. Okay. I don't know what's going on with my camera, but it seems to be that the battery just keeps dying. So I let it charge again. I was to the point of putting contour on my nose. So I need to scoot back a little bit so you can see me, because I actually zoomed the camera in too much, huh? So I'm going to pinch this down really good and run this down the side of my nose. You have to go all the way around the end and make sure you pull it up into your eye. Do both sides of this. This is not the brush I normally use. And now you know why. But it's hard to tell too, because I have a light on this side of my nose. Not on the other side. So it looks a lot darker. Just make sure you always run it up into the eye, because it looks not normal if you don't, if you stop. Okay, that's the end of that. Do the end. Oh, and then I usually do the same thing. I want a little shadow under my lip, because I don't have very big lips and I want them to look bigger. I'm trying to hurry because I don't know if this is gonna, how long it's gonna last. So for blush, I'm gonna use this Tarte blush. It's Blushing Bride is the color. And I'm just gonna put some on. It's very, very can't see it very well. It's very light. I love it, because I don't want pink cheeks. I just want light. And then I'm going to take my kabuki brush, this guy, and try and kind of blend all of that, all my contour, because it's, you know, you put it on really harsh, but you don't want it to stay that way. You just blend it all out. Always go down when you blend your nose. Okay, that's that. All we have left now is my lips and my eyelashes. And since you guys have already seen my eyelashes, or you can go watch the eyelash video, you already know how to do eyelashes. since I'm worried about this battery, I'm gonna turn it off, do my eyelashes and my lips, and come back and show you the final look. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, I have finished the look. This is it. I put on my eyelashes. I actually did forget to curl my lashes and put on. I used this It Cosmetics lash primer. It's black tight line primer. That's what it is, and that's what I use. It's waterproof. It helps your lashes hold a curl, and it doesn't clump or anything because it's a, look at this brush. It's just a tiny little screwy thing. And it's perfect when you wear lashes all the time because all you really need to do is color your lashes, and it's a black primer, so it's awesome. I curled them and put that on before I put my lashes on. Then I put my lashes on and I did my little trick that I do with my highlighter to make it go, to get rid of the droopiness. You know what I mean. You've seen me do it in other videos. So it's my little trick to make it look, you know, sharper at the edge. So you put a little bit of the concealer right here and then you blend it back in with your sponge. And I did that. And I put my lashes on and did my lips. And this is the final look. This is what you guys want. And I put some earrings on too. They don't really do my hoodie justice, do they? Anyways, I hope you liked the video. I hope you learned something. And if there's anything you want to see, comment below. Let me know what you want to see. And since I had so much battery problems, I'll be getting a new battery. And the next time you get to see everything I do. But if you want to see me do my lashes or my little trick, it's in my other videos. It's the other droopy eye, droopy hooded eye. Video has the little trick with the concealer, and then the lashes. I have a whole video on how to put the lashes on. These are Flutter Lashes. I think they're Kelsey. Yeah, Flutter Lashes Kelsey. These are a little more dramatic than I normally use, but I told you guys this was going to be a more exaggerated look, maybe a Valentine's Day look or something like that. And so I won't be using this Rimmel Sparkle liner that I put on because it's just too soft and it doesn't stay in place very well. So I will go back to my L'Oreal Infallible liquid gel lacquer. The blackest black is my favorite eyeliner, but it goes on with a brush, and it's, so it's a little harder to put on than it would be with a pencil. But I hope you liked the video, and if you did, give me a thumbs up. Just make sure you subscribe. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.